gotta do something. Cut my wrists. There's no feeling. There'll be no pain.
Hiya, 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 lift up Jesus higher, cross your burden onto Jesus.
Het is nogal een klus voor deze vissers om een schip aan de kant te krijgen hier in Accra, de hoofdstad van Ghana. Zwaar werk, want het schip moet helemaal van de kust hier ver op land getrokken worden. Verderop in deze stad zijn honderden, duizenden jongeren die geen enkele kracht hebben. Ze zijn getroffen door polio, door de mazelen of door een andere ziekte waardoor ze verlamd of kreupel zijn. Voor hen geen rolstoelen of medische hulp. Joni in Ghana is een reportage die laat zien dat het ook anders kan.
Accra, West Africa, Ghana, and very excited to be delivering wheelchairs and Bibles and books and Braille typewriters for the blind and mounds of materials for the mentally handicapped at two schools there. So we're busy. We're excited. We're
let's going. Go.
Yeah, let's go.
Let's go.
Let's go. I'm ready. Marvelous surprise. If you would have told me last October when I entered that contest that we would have won, it's incredible. But out of 12,000 entries from 125 countries in 25 different languages, we won.
Why did our national air carrier pick you? Because of your smiles?
I don't know, except that the requirement for the contest was that you had to write an essay which would explain what you and your team would do to, quote, bridge the world. And if you won, you got 25 free tickets to go anywhere in the world, all expenses paid for an entire week, cargo space, everything, to accomplish this marvelous task which would, quote, bridge the world. And so I wrote KLM and I said to them, please send us back to Ghana because we were there before and did not have enough wheelchairs to deliver. And we want to go back and bridge the disability differences, the world of disability differences between disabled people in the West and disabled people in the developing nation. And I guess the KLM's committee must have liked the essay, so we're going to Ghana. And it broke my neck there.
Yeah.
And that's why I cannot use my hands or my legs. They don't work. But my mouth works. I sometimes like to think of God as an artist. And sometimes it looks like the artist makes a mistake. Hold this up, Judy. See the mistake?
the mistake, the lines, they look bad. And sometimes when God allows marks in our life that don't look good, we have to trust God as the master artist. Because only God is the one who knows what the finished painting will look like.
Foster, how old are you?
I am 33 years.
Yes. And how many years are you handicapped? What's your leg?
I was a small boy. The day I got the sickness.
Yeah. And all the time, you never had a wheelchair?
I don't have some.
No?
Only today I've got some.
Yeah. How is that? Is it different?
Yes, it's different.
You're happy now?
I'm very, very happy.
Good. Feel the break. Okay. Take that break off.
What made you come to Ghana all the way from America?
Because my burden for people like I am that they might have a better quality of life.
You're handicapped yourself. Do you think, we with able bodies do understand where the disabled go through?
I believe it's a process of education, and I believe as an able-bodied person gets to know a disabled-bodied person, they can begin to look beyond the physical being into the heart, and all of us have the same heart, the same needs, the need to know the Lord Jesus Christ, and giving a wheelchair is another way that we in America can demonstrate the love of the Lord.
Your eyes are smiling.
Yes.
Lift up Jesus higher. Lift up Jesus higher. Cast your burdens unto Jesus, for he cares for you. Cast your burdens unto Jesus, for he cares for you. Higher, 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 higher. Lift up.
I don't know how to say this, but I haven't seen one bitter disabled person here yet. And I have seen scores of people with disabilities, many, many people with disabilities. No one's bitter. No one's angry at a drunk driver. No one's angry at their mother for having gotten them born. No one's angry that they were, disabled in an injury or an illness or a disease. They're happy, happy people. And it's given me a renewed confidence that there's no need for me to ever, ever complain. I think of what the book of James said about how the poor shall inherit the earth. The poor are the ones who are rich in faith. Blessed are those who are poor in spirit. One woman in Ghana said to me yesterday, she said, Johnny, we must believe in Jesus. He is our only hope. Our only hope, she said with a big smile. And I started telling her about how in the books of Isaiah and Jeremiah and Ezekiel and Daniel, that these were the prophets who wrote to people who were poor, in bondage, enslaved in Babylon. And always, always the themes in those Bible books is hope. Hope that Jesus is coming back. Hope that life will one day be better. Hope that God has not abandoned them. And her smile just really brightened to know that, God's word spoke personally to her. And that hope is what makes life worth living when you hope in Christ.
Big bliss is here. What happened?
Okay, it's the cause of the sticks that I'm working with.
The sticks?
Yeah.
What do they do to your hands?
I don't know. Since the time I started using it, all of a sudden, I could see my palm was red about some few minutes later. So it has changed, and the place has become very hard. And sometimes I have to use bleed to remove it. To remove it before I can walk.
Yeah. So, yeah. What happened to you that you're walking with sticks?
Okay. After I was born, I was six years later. I felt sick. And I was taken to the hospital. I was injected. But some few minutes later, I could see I couldn't get up again. I couldn't do anything. I couldn't walk. So, anytime my mother or father have to raise me up to walk, and this thing continues, it is sometimes I could see that I could no longer move anymore.
How is the situation in general for handicapped people in Ghana?
Very, very, very poor. Yeah, because. As I said, I started earlier on, you are not be taken care of. Sometimes, if you don't struggle for your own, the whole of today, I can say you may not get something from your stomach. You can sleep without taking anything. But the situation, to my side, is very poor. Yeah. I believe not to me alone, but to other people. Yeah. So we are waiting, and we are praying to Almighty God for a better tomorrow.
Gerda, you're involved in Johnny and Friends, and you're serving on the board of directors.
Yes.
We sit here in the middle of people with a mental handicap. You have a physical handicap. What happened to you?
In 1982, I was in a car accident, and I don't remember the details. The Lord is so good that I don't have to remember. But I got burned 65%. And the doctors in San Diego, in California, gave me a 4% chance to survive.
You're
4%,
here.
Yes, yes, it's not very much. And I thank the Lord that I'm here.
Yeah. How do you cope, if I may ask that question, with the fact that I've seen a picture of you before. You were a very attractive, beautiful lady. How do you cope with that?
How do I cope? I think the Lord gives me strength every day. Otherwise, I could not cope. Yeah. And it's exciting what He has shown me through all that. And today, when you say, how do I cope? I need to have that confidence. Not the self-confidence, but the confidence in God. That's how I cope.
Yeah.
So I could be an outcast of society.
Yeah.
And only by the Lord's grace. And that's why I pray that lots of volunteers would come in here. And it's not that when you volunteer, you need to do that every day. Do an hour a week. Start with an hour a week.
Yeah. What does it do for you to be here and to distribute wheelchairs to those that have never ever been able to be in a wheelchair, even to think about it, because it's too expensive?
It makes me feel very inadequate, because I can see what we have in the United States and how ungrateful we are. And how we complain about everything. And there, a wheelchair, even a used wheelchair, is appreciated, and they dance and are just the happiest smiles and everything. I will never forget that.
One person, actually several people, who have been seated in their wheelchairs, they are expressionless. They don't smile. Their faces are just like stone. And at first I thought, oh, these people must not be happy that they're receiving their wheelchairs, I thought. But then I was sitting in the church, and one woman leaned over to me in her brand new wheelchair, her eyes glistening with tears, and she patted my hand and said, thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. Barely a whisper. And my heart burst with joy, because I knew that the only reason they were expressionless is that they were overwhelmed, speechless. They had no words. They just could not believe that they would be the recipients of such a gift. I should learn to think the best and not think the worst when I see someone not smile. They're just simply overwhelmed.
See, you become very emotional in one of the church meetings. Why was that? What gripped your heart?
This same woman who, when she was seated in her wheelchair, was without a smile, no expression. She was the one of whom I thought might not be happy that she had received such a gift. She was also the one who, in sitting next to me, patted my arm and said that she was very grateful. Thank you for the wheelchair, she said. Well, they started dancing, hiya, 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 and all the women in their beautiful African colorful dress with their handkerchiefs and their hats, they're shuffling and swaying and just dancing to the music. And
Nami miti waikau, miti waikau, miti waikau, miti waikau, masia miti umpani mijifu.
Someone once said that Jesus is not the prophet to winners, but always to losers. It is those who consider themselves the last, the least, the littlest, the lost. He holds feasts for the forgotten. And if we can only see ourselves, as little, least, last, lost, small, then his strength, his power becomes big. Jesus becomes large in our hearts. And a Bible for you. May I sign it to you?
Higher, 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 higher. Lift up Jesus, higher, 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 higher. Lift up Jesus, higher.
All right, that's great, Vita. You know that. That's an old familiar song, huh? That's great. May I pray for you, Lord Jesus? Thank you for Vita. Thank you for her life. Thank you that you, God of the universe, love Vida. God loves Vida. Jesus loves Vida. Thank you for that. I pray for my sister that she might know your forgiveness in a deep personal way, reaching down into her heart. Love her, surround her, give her your comfort and peace. And be glorified in her life, Lord Jesus, as she lifts you higher, higher, higher in her heart. In your name, Jesus, amen. 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 God is great. God is good. I tried to memorize their smiles. You know, I often do that. People I fall in love with, I end up painting their faces in my head. And I hold that painting in my heart as a treasured memory. And already I've painted several faces of young men here, young people. And I'm going to remember them. I'll remember them not only when I go back to the United States, I'll remember them in heaven. And they will come up to me. And we'll have the best time fellowshipping, rejoicing, praising God, running on our strong, straight, resurrected legs, grateful, glorified knees that are no longer scarred and scuffed and calloused, strong, healthy bodies. And we will talk of this moment and laugh and point down on earth and say, wasn't God good giving us that song? How great He is. And that's what I think of when I'm in a place like this, that I will remember this. Paint this painting well. Take this photograph in my mind and don't let it fade, because this is worth keeping for heaven.